What is going on, guys? Today we're talking about drones and how you can use them at your wedding. They're pretty cool, but they're loud, so we'll pick this up at the studio.
There is no denying that it looks really cool, but only when done correctly. So here are some shoulds and shouldn'ts of droning at your wedding. So a drone shot that is awesome to have is that epic grand wide shot of your venue, that everything's looking great and it's up high in the air and you see like all the horizon behind the venue, and it's so epic. It's awesome. Now there are a few things that depend on that. One, you have to make sure that the venue actually looks good from the air. You have to make sure the roof looks nice. Now, most people don't know this because people don't check out the roof of a building, but some venues will actually have solar panels on their roof, and solar panels just don't look good. But hey, at least the venue's saving a little money on their electric bill. Another big thing to consider when doing a drone of the venue is weather and airspace permitting. Well, what do I mean by that? Well, weather, if it's a little too windy, raining, snowing, any sort of precipitation is, well, obviously a no-go. Airspace permitting, well, that's something a little tricky and not many people know about, so you can't actually fly a drone anywhere near an airport or certain restricted areas that you can only see on a geographical chart for pilots and anyone navigating airspace. Different airports have different airspace restrictions, but a general rule of thumb is that if your venue is near an airport, you might not be able to have a drone shot. So something that I like to do is when I'm shooting a wedding, I will actually not shoot a drone shot on the actual wedding day. I'll shoot on a different day that has the ideal light. I'm just gonna tell you in the field, hold on. Just wrapped up another shoot with the drone. Did it a different day than the wedding because I wanted to wait for the ideal opportunity that matched the tone and the mood of the wedding film. And more importantly, I just decided to do a drone shot on a different day so I could focus on that as opposed to just quick popping the drone in the air. And I wanted to really focus all my attention on the bride and groom on the wedding day. So focus on the bride and groom on the wedding day, focus on the drone shots another day. All right, so here is a big should not drone during the outdoor ceremony that you're having. It sounds really nice, you know, you have a nice outdoor ceremony, everything's looking great, gorgeous scenery, epic landscapes. You should stick a drone in the air, Christian. No. Why would I not put a drone in the air during your beautiful ceremony? Because you would not hear your beautiful ceremony. Drones are super loud and noisy and they sound like obnoxious weed whackers. So here is a simulated example of what it would sound like having a drone at your ceremony.
I promise to continue to laugh with you and experience new things. I promise to remember neither of us are perfect, but I strive to remind myself we are perfect for each other.
If you need any more convincing, everyone's gonna look like ants from that high perspective because the drone's up high and then everyone's just gonna look tiny. Lastly, if I'm flying the drone at your ceremony, who's shooting your ceremony? Even with a second shooter taking someone away from a grounded camera, getting that aisle shot, that critical shot for the kiss and the vows, it doesn't make sense. I would never choose a drone shot that's just up high, everyone looks like ants. Makes no sense. In theory, the idea of a drone during a ceremony is cool, but when it gets to practicality, it is just, it's a disaster. Another should not is during your photo session, having a drone kind of hover above you, doing some cool bird's eye view thing. That's not a good idea. Why is it not a good idea? Well, actually it's illegal from the FAA. That's a big reason. The FAA mandates that you can't actually fly over anybody with your UAV drone, so it's actually illegal. The reason why it's illegal is, like anything, Murphy's Law can happen and the drone could malfunction, a gust of wind could come out of nowhere, the drone could fall, crash, and hit someone, and those blades, even though they're plastic, they're moving at pretty high RPMs, that's gonna hurt. So we don't need any of that on the wedding day. Let's just avoid that. We can get plenty of great shots on the ground with our cameras, then just a drone zipping all over. Zip, 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 zip. No, no. Drones are great for one or two shots in the film, but that's it. The rest of it is best captured on the ground. And finally, a should, if possible, is a staged action of transportation, as sexy as that sounds. So if you are renting a Rolls Royce, or you have a limo or anything, or maybe a custom car, something that you guys are driving from like the church to the reception hall and you're in an open area, hey, let's bring up the drone, get a little following shot of the drone, yeah, like the car's driving down the road and the drone's following. Like, I think that's a really cool shot to show that, like, we're moving from the church to the reception hall. You know, if you're getting married in like a lakeside property and you go on a boat, that's super cool. But those are planned, those are staged, and most importantly, they are safe. Anything that can happen will happen, and if something bad does happen, that's gonna put a damper on the day, and you just wanna make sure that you're being safe, because overall, it's the best move. You know, when it comes down to it, I'm not gonna put the drone up just for the sake of getting a drone shot. You know, the story is about you guys. It's about the couple, and it's not about just a drone shot. That's, you know, they're cool. They offer a lot of production value, and they make the wedding film look great if done right and if everything has a reason. Just like the drone, everything is a tool and it has its purpose. But that is it for me today, guys. I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit about drones, how you can apply it to your wedding day to make your wedding film that much better. If you enjoy this wedding content, go like my Facebook page, follow me on Instagram, and go check out my work at christiangalicfilms.com, and I will see you in the next video.